Jamba.
Oh, that protein berry workout with whey.
Oh, it's only in my eye. Cheers. All right, taste test. It tastes like an acai bowl.
I love that.
And my drink holders are avocado.
So, I partially hate doing videos like these because camera people are very polarizing. They're either pro-Sony or they're pro-Canon. And if you talk down on Canon, those Canon people will come for you. And if you talk down on Sony, those Sony people will come for you. If you know me, I use the Sony a7 III. I've used that for the last 2 years, and it's really set off my career, honestly. I'm a full-time real estate videographer, and I do YouTube on the side. However, I've added a new camera to my collection, and that would be the Canon RP. What did you guys think? Beautiful or what? It's definitely beautiful. And man, this thing is very underrated. Very underrated. I know what you're thinking, that this is a downgrade. You're thinking to yourself, the Canon RP is definitely a downgrade from the Sony a7 III. And I suppose you could say yes from a specs standpoint. In fact, yeah. That's the truth. However, it's not about the gear, it's about the person and the traits that they know with the skills that they have. Now, basically, I'm not here to convert anybody from Canon to Sony or Sony to Canon. I'm here to tell you guys the three main reasons why I switched over from Sony to Canon. What's going on, everybody? Editor Alfred here, and this is a prime example of why I just am irritated with the Sony sometimes. Just watch these clips in the next couple seconds here for the next 30 seconds, and just watch how much the auto white balance just fluctuates. I don't have any color grading, nor do I have any color correcting on top of this. It's just pure footage right out of the camera. And yeah, just take a look for yourself. Okay, I think that's it.
If you're new here, welcome to the Wave Gretzky Show. My name is Alfred Romero, and it's a pleasure to meet you guys. Definitely scroll down and consider subscribing. We just rounded up onto 3K here, and we have a goal to get to 10,000 by the end of the year. And every single one of you guys counts, because we're already in June, so that means we only have 7 months left. Now, 7,000 subscribers in 7 months? Sounds impossible, but I don't think it is. I really need you guys to come through for me on this one, because I'm trying to make YouTube my full-time job. Now, in order to do that, I need subs, so that way I can get sponsorship deals and maybe even a little bit better ad revenue. You hear me? So do your brother a solid and hit that subscribe button. But anyways, here's the three main reasons why I got this Canon RP when I already have the Sony a7 III. And for the first reason, is very simple, and it's gonna sound like such a little thing, but it's so huge, is this flip out screen. This flip out touchscreen at that. And I know what you're gonna say, that the Sony a7 S3 has already answered that problem, and that is very true, but they've answered that problem for a premium of $3,500. And that's not a price that I'm willing to pay for a camera. I mean, I can get exactly what I need to get done with this thing. This camera body only came in at $899 and came in at $1,400 with the kit lens. And this kit lens is a 24-105 f/4. Now, I don't have a problem with that, because I can do exactly what I need to do with an f/4. I don't need that low bokeh all the time like how I'm using now on the f/2.8. I'm cool with it. And actually, for the last three videos, I've been cool with it. And I'm sure none of you guys have even noticed that I switched cameras. I've had this thing for about 2 weeks now, and I could say I honestly love this thing. I used to be a Canon user, like I was saying before, and I used to have the 6D Mark II. It had the flip out screen, had the 1080p, it even had the full size sensor. And when the a7 III came out, everybody and their mamas jumped the ship to go over to Sony. You can't say that I'm wrong, because you know I'm right. And the only people that stayed are the people that were sponsored by Canon. Anyways though, but don't get me wrong, even in the last couple months, a lot of people have been switching over to Sony because of the a7 III, because it's answered a lot of those questions. But if you're like myself and you don't have a lot of money to be spending on camera gear like that, then this might be a really good option for you. I was thinking to myself when I bought the a7 III that, man, I just really need that 4K. Man, I just really need that 120 in slow motion. which is not true at all. Like, I only use 120 maybe 6 times a year, and I can get away with using 60. I'll be just fine. I promise you. And as far as like the 1080p versus the 4K thing, yeah, it is nice to have 4K. Don't get me wrong, it makes your videos very crisp. It just gives it that extra quality, but I could still tell the same story that I would with this. This actually even shoots 4K just at a cropped sensor. I would just need to get a wider lens if I was gonna be doing stuff like this in 4K. So again, still no problem, because guess what? I never even had 4K 60 frames a second with the Sony a7 III, so I was up-raising all my slow-mo anyways. So that's exactly the same thing I would be doing here if I was shooting in 4K. Still the same problem. Now, reason number two, and again, this is gonna sound a little as well, is the Canon colors. The colors that come out of the Sony a7 III are horrendous, Jesus. I've had footage that looks just extra green like a turtle. I've had footage that comes out extra red like a stoplight. And let me tell you, the tint on this thing is just so hideous. I never had this kind of problem when I was using my 6D Mark II, and Canon just has these color signs dialed in. That's what they're known for, literally. Their vibrance and their colors and their reds and yada yada. Color grading and color correcting, I want to spend as little as time as this on possible as possible, because the story is way more important than the color grading. And again, you can say that they've answered those problems with the Sony a7 S3, but I don't have that kind of money to spend on a DSLR camera. But yeah, that's my second reason. Now, the third and final reason is ergonomics. Really, that's what it comes down to. And there's a couple things on this camera that prove that point. So on the Sony a7 III, the shutters button is right here on the front. Let me see if I can get rid of my face there. The shutter button is a wheel that's right here. That button on here is right here. Now also too, it has the same placement of the back for the aperture right here. But the thing about this one is it has a lock button. It has a lock button right here, so that way even if you hit it, it'll still stay at the same aperture. Now, I used to mess with this thing on accident all the time, and I'd be recording for 30 minutes or more and then realize I wasn't even in the right settings that I wanted to be in. And that was another thing as well. The record button. The record button is on top on this thing, and with the a7 III, it's on the back. So just recording myself is a huge hassle. This camera is great, and I'm still gonna keep it, just so you guys know. I'm just only gonna be using it for work, because it's the perfect camera for behind the camera, just not in front of the camera. And to address the other two big complaints that people have about this thing is battery life and the SD card placement. So first, the SD card placement. A lot of people are used to having their SD cards out here on the side, right here. There's usually some type of flap right here that comes out, and you could shove your SD card in there. It's underneath next to the battery. And for a lot of people, that's a problem. I'm not even too sure why, but I love this little closer latch right here, because I could just close it like that. With the Sony a7 III, when I close it, I actually have to keep holding it and then put the latch back. That doesn't sound like that big of a problem, but trust me, if you're like only using one hand, it's a huge problem. Secondly, the battery life. People are saying that this battery life is just obviously not that good in comparison, and obviously, clearly, it would not be on a side-to-side test, but I have yet to have an issue where this thing dies on me in public when I'm filming. I might encounter that, but again, it's nothing a second battery can't fix. I should be perfectly fine shooting all day on this thing. And lastly, regarding ergonomics, I just love the way that this thing feels. I miss the way that Canon feels in your hand. I think this is like one of the perfect cameras for YouTube, especially if you're just getting into YouTube, just getting into photography or anything from wanting to do it. When people talk about the best camera ever, I think there's two different ways to use a camera: behind the camera and in front of the camera. And if you're in front of the camera, this answers a lot of those questions. That is my spiel, and thank you for coming to my TED Talk today. If you guys enjoyed this video, definitely scroll down and consider subscribing. Look, what do I have to do to convince you guys to do it? Because we're on a mission here. Please give the video a like. Don't dislike it. I know I might have said some things that you might not have agreed with, but that's okay. We're here to support one another. Anyways though, guys, my new upload schedule, I am uploading on Mondays and Thursdays now. I was originally only uploading on Thursdays, but now I'm trying to do twice a week because I care about you guys that much and I want to pump out the content to you guys. So with that being said, I will see you guys next week, because this will be coming out on Thursday, and I will see you on Monday. Peace, guys. Have a good weekend. Yeah.
them.